Hello all, welcome to Tracy's Purple Pad, where I will be showing you today the new summer catalogue for Stampin Up. It's the annual catalogue where we have lots of new goodies. Right, there we go. So this is the 2020 Stampin Up catalogue, and it's laid out a little differently this year. We start off with a couple of pages of all-inclusive kits. That means you can you get everything you need to make a whole set, usually 15 cards. This is my absolute favourite one. This is a slightly bigger picture. I hope you can see that okay. And you get all of that. However, you can buy just the refill kit, and if you bought just the refill kit, you wouldn't get the ribbon, you wouldn't get the dies, and you wouldn't get the stamp set, but you'd get everything else for £21, which I think is incredible value. I really like that one. There are four kits in all, and you can order from most of them, or at least two of them. And there is also another two in the new beginners catalogue. You will find a copy of both the catalogues in my files on Purple Pad Crafts on Facebook. You can just click on them and that will take you straight to the catalogue so you can have a look through. They're all lovely. Then we come to the first of the new suites. What's a suite? Well, it's a stamp set that comes with a whole host of things that coordinate with it. Papers, embellishments, dies, punches. If you want it all, the suite is the cheaper option, but all of it is available separately as well. There is this is a particularly large suite with two bundles. Okay, what's a bundle? A bundle is a stamp set that comes with matching dies or a matching punch, and you can buy them separately if you would rather. You don't have to buy them together, but if you buy a bundle, you do save a few pounds on the two items together. But do remember to order the die bundle or the punch bundle code number, otherwise you will pay the normal price. Where you see in the catalogue a stamp set with a cream image like this one, that means it comes with a punch that coordinates with it, and it will punch out the image that you can see in cream. Where it comes in grey, that means it comes with matching dies that will die cut those particular images. So you will see that on pretty much every stamp set that has a coordinating die or punch. Punch and stamp bundle sets can be found listed from page 168, and dies and stamp set bundles can be found from 173. As you go looking through the catalogue, you will notice that some are offered as cling and some are offered as photopolymer. I'm just going to show you what the difference is. So photopolymer, pretty forward, simple really, plasticky, rubbery, sort of just sticks, and I would actually call those cling stamps because they do cling. But Stampin Up have a range of rubber stamps which they now call their cling stamps because they've put an extra sticky cling on the underside, as you can see. And so these are the cling stamps. So if you've got where there's a choice of stamps, I actually prefer the rubber stamps. I think you get a much nicer solid image, and they're easier to stamp with, and you can find them easier if you drop one. So that's the difference between the two types of sticky. We do also sell now sheets of the sticky cling. So if you've got old Stampin' Up sets where they used to not cling very well to your stamping your pad that you're stamping it up with, you can now buy that sticky, and it's clear, so you can just put it on over the top, which is a good idea. if you're using our Stamparatus tool, which is this, obviously mine is very dirty and very used. I have barely used an ordinary stamp pad since I've had this, because this makes it so much easier. You get such a good image every time. But if you're going to use this, you may need an extra sheet of something. I've just stuck a little bit of foam, felt, under there, just because the polymer ones just need a little bit extra height. You won't need that with the cling stamps. We have 6 background stamps, which are sort of not quite this size, so almost the same size as the stamp pad, and they are a whole they're just I think we've got one that's birch, one that's camouflage, one that's chicken wire, one that's wood. There's various different sort of background techniques that you can use with those. And they are available as cling or wood mount. That's the only wood mount we have now. As you go through the catalogue, you will find that some of the stamp sets say distinctive. See if I can find a good example. I'll just quickly flick through. I'm not going right through the catalogue with you, because you need to do that in your own time to have a look through. I will tell you that we do have lots of lovely just greetings. And if you're getting started, a set of greetings is a very good one to have. But if you can get one that's got greetings as well as like this one, then that's really good. I'm trying to find one that's distinctive that will explain what it is. Okay, so I'll go with Blossoms in Bloom because I absolutely love this. So this has got a distinctive stamp with it, and what that means is it will give you a filled in image of the stamp. So it's not like this one where it's just like a drawn image, it's actually filled in, and this one gives a very watery image, like you've done a water painting with that one. Most of the ones that say distinctive will have that kind of, see again we have here the Healing Hugs, which is a really nice little set. The rose and the leaf have the markings on, so they have, you can actually see the lines in the petals and the leaves, the veins in the leaves. That's what that means. It means it's got a more distinctive pattern. If you've seen a lot like I did and you thought, oh my god, I want all of that, what I've just looked at, and there is some really lovely stuff in here this year. If I hadn't have already joined as a demonstrator 3.5 years ago now, this catalogue would definitely have made me join, because as a demonstrator you get 20% discount on your orders. Now, it's not a lot, but if you only want to be a hobby demonstrator, and that means that you only want to do it for yourself, maybe for your friends to order the stuff, you will still get that 20% discount. But if you want to build a business, as I'm trying to do, every time you go up slightly, so that means every time you reach an achievement, you go up a little bit. So if I was to go up to the next level, I'm bronze at the moment, I've been bronze elite and I've gone back down to bronze because I haven't spent enough. But if you go up to bronze elite, you then get an extra 5% discount, and so on and so on. So as you go up to silver, silver elite, gold, gold elite. And you can go up more if you build your team. So if you get team members, you're gradually getting more, and or just for yourself with your sales. It's a great company to work for. They do not put any pressure on you at all. They give you great tips, great guidance, lots of things to follow. There's loads of Facebook pages for the demonstrators. There's lots of support. The customer support team are absolutely fantastic. If you contact them, they will, if you email them, they'll ring you straight back and they resolve any problems. If you ever buy something you are not happy with, please return it. They will either give you a refund or a completely new item. No questions asked. They really good. But I love being a demonstrator. I get the perks, I get the training, I get incentives. I don't have to build a team unless I want to. You don't get any pressure to meet your targets. If you don't meet your targets and you drop down and you have to not be a demonstrator anymore, that's fine. You can rejoin at any time. And again, you get all the benefits. There's no reason not to, really. And until the end of June, which I know is only a couple of days, you can choose £130 worth of goods for your kit, but it has to be on the dot. And you only pay £99, and you can choose whatever you want to be in that kit. It doesn't have to be anything specific. You can choose what you would like as a starting up kit. I have made a few kits up that come to exactly £130 that you would only pay £99 for, and I am going to put those on my files. I've done various different kits to suit various different people, hobby demonstrators, people who want to start a business, somebody who's got nothing and wants to completely get started in stamping. They will all be on my files later today. So please have a look, and if you think you'd like all those things, let me know. Or you can actually click on my page, on my shopping page link, and you can go to the top and you will see a section that will say join, and if you click on that, it will take you through what you have to do. But I've never looked back. I actually joined because there was so much I wanted. I knew I was going to easily spend £130, and I didn't want to spend that if I didn't have to. So I did spend that, but I only spent £99. You've got until the 30th, which is 2 days. If you join this month, you can also pick any bundle, that's a die and stamp set or a punch and stamp set, for free on top of your £130 worth of goodies. So that's excellent. They do that throughout the year, so if you do miss it this time, when the next catalogue comes out, they'll probably do it again, so don't panic. Okay, so I'm just going to flick through. I want to show you just a few things that we do. I'm going to show you this sweet quickly because this is my favourite. I've just got this one. This is another suite where you get everything comes with it, all the coordinating goods, ribbons, embellishments, your punch or your die, your papers. I didn't want the whole lot, so I just ordered the punch, the papers, which are absolutely amazing. And you get 48 sheets. They're double-sided. There's four of each pattern. And they are just amazing. The stamp set, which you've already seen me show. I had a go quickly at making a little card, which I've put a bit of bling on just to make it look a little more like bubbles. And I do love it. We do have, I'll show you just some of my favourites. So we have Dino Days, Floral Essence, which you can also purchase a stamp that goes with that, and that cuts out this one, and if you double it or treble it up, it looks very effective. My absolute favourite, Free as a Bird. Sailing Home, which is very popular with the scrapbookers. It's really nice and it makes lovely mail cards. Back on Your Feet is a fun animal one, which is about get well. But you could easily use the images for children's cards as well. This again is another one of my favourites. Beautiful Friendship. It's a distinctive. It's got watery type patterns. And this is my newest one, Jar of Flowers, which I showed you the punch, I think, didn't I? Here, there's the punch. Please be careful when ordering papers. Please go to the back, page 148, where it will show you all of the papers. Now, do read it first. They're not all 12 by 12. So, the Forever Flowers, the the Forever Flowers for Every Season, sorry, and the Playing with Patterns sets are 6x6, not 12x12. So if I put a star by them, they are 12x12. But just be careful of that when ordering them. Don't think you're getting 12x12 and then you're not. The Whale of a Time are 6x6. The new In Colours are 6x6, and the designer series paper that coordinates with all our colours are also 6x6. They used to be 12x12. I don't know why they've changed it, but that doesn't have to stop you using them for scrapbooking. And I'm going to do a whole class on using a 6x6 pages to scrapbook with, because there's no reason why you can't scrapbook with 6x6 pages onto plain cardstock. I should do that at a later date. Do check out all the back pages. It shows you all our accessories, trimmers, etc. I showed you the Stamper Artist already. If you can afford to purchase this as one of your first purchases, I would get this. It's about £49. It might be 50 now, I can't remember. But as you can see, I've got a stamped image on here, and I've placed them exactly where I need them to stamp out I'll just do it quickly on this bit of paper. So I'm going to stamp up. I hope you're not getting my head in the view there. Stamp it up. Put my paper in. Hold it down with my magnet. Press it down. And there you go. But can you see, I didn't quite get all of the flower. If I go over it again and press it down, and it's perfect. It doesn't smudge, it doesn't smear, it hasn't. So you can't do that by hand and get a perfect image. And then I would cut that out. I would punch out this piece with the punch. And then this piece would sit over the top, and then you would put your card with your flowers on the top, and all you would see is the jam jar with the stems on. And these are sticky, so that you've got sticky either side for putting them on. Brilliant, love that. I'm just going to give you a couple of top tips. We do re-inking ink. So if you don't want to go to the expense of buying stamp pads, the normal size ones, which are these are our normal size stamp pads. If you don't think you're going to use them enough to worry about having that, why not get a set of 5 of these little ones for £8.25 and 5 colours, and that comes to £25.50, and you get you'll have 5 different colours to play with. Alternatively, at the back of the catalogue, there are 8 ready inked ones that you can get, different lovely colours or bright colours, for £22. Or you could buy a set of our Stampin' Write markers. These are the old style markers, and these are water based, so you can actually draw colour onto your stamps with these and then use them to stamp out your image. You don't have to have the ink pad if you've got those. And for colouring in, I highly recommend our stamping blends. We only sell them now in a pack of 2, but we've got lots and lots and lots of colours, and you get a light and a dark in each colour. I think they're £8.50 or £8.99 for 2, which sounds a lot, but it really isn't, because they last and last and last. And I have never coloured with anything so lovely. And I've, through the years, I've had several sets of colouring pens. I've still got most of them, and they're all just stuck in a drawer because I only use these now, because they're like writing with painting. They're like paintbrushes. They're so soft and the ink comes out so lovely and you get a perfect match every time. You don't get any lines, they all blend, and you can even buy blender pens to blend them together even more. But you don't need those really if you've got these. We have a range of different punches that go with different sets that we've got. And I must show you the tulip, because this is one of my favourites at the moment. This is the tulip punch. But when I saw it this way up and I thought, I don't know, that looks like I could make other things with that. So I've had a little play and I've made an owl, which I think is quite cute. And he was all made from punches that I have, but mostly with just this one. The only different ones I had to use were the round ones for his eyes. So you can also make a snowman, a penguin, a squid, a ghost, and a pinwheel from that. So I love repurposing pads wherever possible. If you look at the Butterfly Gala stamp set, you will notice that the stamps come like that. They are one on top of the other. That is so when you stamp up and then you're going to cut them out with your punch, you get a perfect placement every time. If you try and do them singly, it'll be very difficult. So that's why they come like that. These ones, we have a cat and a dog. I don't have the cat. This was last year's. We had a sweep last year that this went with. We haven't got the sweep this year, but we still got the pads, because these punches, because they make really lovely images. Please have a look. There's lots of tags, punches. We've got a new tag punch which will punch out three different sizes, and I hope to get that later on in the year before Christmas, so that we can do a tag class before Christmas. If you've enjoyed having a look through there briefly and I've inspired you, I'm going to, when I finish this video, I'm going to put another video up of some samples that I've managed to find of various different stamp sets that are in the catalogue, and I'm going to post them onto my Purple Pads Craft page, so that you can have a look through at some of the examples that I've found and I've had printed out. I will also put some examples on a file so that you can look at them at your leisure. And please feel free to message me with any questions.